Welcome to Learn Commerce PU Online Classes. Don't forget to like our video and subscribe our YouTube channel for all the updates.
Hello my dear students, welcome back to First Commerce Business Studies online classes. In the previous class, we had discussed about the important documents required to get the incorporation certificate or certificate of incorporation. Correct, right? So let's move to discuss what is the meaning of incorporation and what are the important documents are required to get the incorporation certificate once again. So incorporation means, see, once the registrar of firms, means when the registrar is satisfied with the all the legal formalities, means completion of formalities for the registration, a certificate of incorporation issued. Certificate of incorporation is issued by the registrar of companies. So registration is with that, when they are ready to issue the certificate of incorporation, that day is considered as the birth date of the company. Okay, say for example 6th January 2019, they applied all the submitted all the documents to the registrar of companies, and all the documents are satisfied about the completion of formalities. Registrar is satisfied all the document which is submitted by either promoters of the company, then that after 2 days they will issue a certificate of incorporation. Then when you submit all the documents to the registrar of firms, that day is considered as birth date of the company. From that day you can enter to any contract. From that day you can legally involve with any other operations of the business activity. Getting my point? That day is considered as birth date of the company. So the certificate of incorporation may be therefore called as what? Birth certificate of the company, and with the effect from November 1, 2000, registrar of companies give CIN number to the companies. That means corporate identity number. Corporate identity number. So registration certificate of incorporation issued to the company only when the registrar is satisfied with the formal legal document which is submitted by the promoters of the company, then they will issue incorporation certificate to the company. Okay, so that's why that day incorporation certificate of incorporation is considered as what? Birth certificate of the company. So and the important point is, now from November 1, 2000, registrar of companies will issue CIN number to the companies. CIN number means corporate identity number. Let's see what are the important documents are required, which is already discussed in the previous class. Once again I'll explain. First document is required, that is MOA, Memorandum of Association. It must contain the clear objects of the company. And the next one is Articles of Association. That Articles of Association contains specifies all the important rules and regarding relates to the internal management of the company, and the next one is written consent of proposed director, means they are agreed to the rules and regulations about the issue of shares and debentures or issue of securities and about the conditions related to buying and about the payment for these shares and all. So that is about written consent of proposed directors to act as a directors. They have to sign it and then they have to submit the document. Next one is the agreement, if any, with the proposed director or with the management, means or with the manager or whole time director. In many organization there is concepts are there, full time director, whole time director, like full time director or for director just for 6 months, like that. So if such any agreements are there within the individual and the company, then they have to prepare that document and they have to submit to the registrar of companies. Then a copy of the registrar's letter approving that the name of the company. Once I told that the name of the company must be approved by the registrar, correct, right? So because if any undesirable name is given by the promoter, then they are not approved, means registrar is not approved, then they again they have to give any other name. Say for example, if any name is already exist or the name gives some wrong meaning to the general public, then that names are not approved by the registrar. So another name should be given to the registrar for the approval purpose. After approving that name, that the registrar office will give a certificate that also must be attached with this documents. So the agreement, if any, with the proposed director or the manager or a copy of the registrar's letter approving that the name of the company, that also must that also attached to the important documents. And the next one is statutory declaration. It is, once I told already I told that it was a document stating that all the important legal formalities are prepared and submitted or compiled with the compiled and submitted to the registrar of firms, and these statement is signed by the advocate or the chartered accountant or the manager or the director, okay, whose name is mentioned in the AOA or MOA. And the next one is a notice about the exact address of the registered office. At the time of when we preparing important documents, at that time registered office, state of the registered office must be mentioned, but not exact address is not required at that stage. But at the incorporation stage, they have to mention the exact address of the state within which the proposed company is to be situated. Getting my point? That is what a notice about the exact address of the registered office also included in that important document to get the incorporation certificate. The next important document is document evidence of the payment of registration fees. To give the certificate of incorporation, registrar of firms receive some fees for the to give a registration certificate to any company, and are told that is depends on the quantity or the depends on the amount of authorized capital. So that document payment receipt of payment fees also must be attached with the important documents. Then they have to submit to the registrar of firms of the state, registrar of companies of the state within which the proposed company is to be situated. And let's see the effect of the certificate of incorporation. effect of the certificate of incorporation. See, a company is legally born on the date printed on the certificate of incorporation. Once I told that if you submit all the documents on 1st January 2019, that is, it becomes legally entity to the perpetual succession on such date. Okay, let's see the effect of the certificate of incorporation. A certificate of incorporation is a conclusive evidence of the registrar of the incorporation of the company. See, registrar of the incorporation of the company. So once the certificate of registration is issued to the company, then they can legally involve with the business activities. Okay, so incorporation certificate is very important to run the business or to start business operation to the company form of organization. So a company is legally born on the date on which is printed on the certificate of incorporation, which is certificate of commencement. So it becomes legally entity with the perpetual succession, and from that date they can start their operation, then they can continue till the end of as they want. Okay, that is what about the certificate of incorporation. So some of the important examples about this incorporation certificate are, once the document of registration were filled, say for example certificate of you as a company, as a promoter of the company, you submitted all the documents on 6th January 2019, and after 2 days after verifying all these documents, registrar of companies will issue the certificate of incorporation on 8th January, then the birth date of the company is considered, 6th January is considered as a birth date of the company. So after 6th January, if you enter any document, then that is considered as a valid contract, valid agreement. So when which date is specified in the certificate of incorporation, from that day you can legally enter with any contract with any entity. That is what the importance of incorporation certificate. Say for example, already I told that you on 6th January you submitted all the documents to the registrar of companies. After verifying the documents on 8th January, certificate of incorporation is issued by the registrar of companies. Then, but 6th January is considered as the birth date of the company. Clear? Getting my point? So that is one point. And a person, if forged the signature of others on the memorandum of association, that also considered as valid. Once the registration of certificate was issued by the registrar of firms, then no one can alter any changes, no one can alter the important points or the rights of the incorporation of certificate, okay, again and again. So whenever any deficiency in the formalities of the certificate, or in deficiency in the formalities or at the time of preparation of documents and all, once the incorporation certificate is issued to the company, then that is final. If any illegal objects are mentioned in the MOA, or MOA, but registrar has issued incorporation certificate, then there is no one can alter that, because once the incorporation certificate issued, that is final. The only one way to wind up that organization is closing down the organization through the legal formalities, unless otherwise no one can alter that a certificate of incorporation, or no one can give any complaints regarding that and all. So that is what about the effect of certificate of incorporation. So on the issue of certificate of incorporation, a private company can immediately start its operation, but for the public company, they have to undergo with two more important stages, that is capital subscription and commencement of business and other important documents. Private company can start immediate after getting the incorporation certificate from the registrar of firms. Private company can start its operation because it cannot issue any shares, or means any shares or debentures to the general public. They collect funds to run the business from relatives or friends, or by individually they can pool the resources to run the business in effective manner, but it does not likely happen to the public company, because public company have to attract public by issuing prospectus and other, that is what capital subscription stage, they have to undergo with that stage. But once the certificate of incorporations is received by the promoters from the registrar of firms of companies, then private company can start its operation. That is about the incorporation stage and the effect of the certificate of incorporation. I hope you understood this concept. Correct, right? So this is about incorporation and effect of the certificate of incorporation. Thank you for watching this video.
Don't forget to like our video and subscribe our YouTube channel for all the updates.